I love action movies, especially when a car passes through a building. And I know it can be dangerous, but when you watch it on TV, you just don't care about the danger because we are outside of the scene. So we just enjoy the moment. But if we pay attention every time in a movie when a car accident happens, nurses try to save the patient by connecting him to a device that plus change curves that only doctors know the meaning of. In 2009, I was a student in the fourth year in computer science at the National Advanced School of Engineering of Yaounde. And every time I was watching this device on TV, I was asking myself, what is it? And these curves, what do they represent? How can I use my skills to develop a software that can do the same thing in my way? And day after day, my curiosity was growing. And one day, during a database course that I have certainly found very boring, I decided to leave the classroom to find a cardiologist that could help me to satisfy my curiosity. This is how, inside the General Hospital of Yaounde, I met the Professor Samuel Kinge, a cardiologist who will learn me everything about the basics of biomedical engineering and cardiology. He was waiting for a good engineer for a very long time, and for me, I was looking just for one thing, a good reason to skip classes. So everything was perfect. And during 1 year with the professor, we have been working about the digital signal processing, and under his supervision, I have developed a small application that was able to detect heartbeats inside the heart signal of a patient and compute the heart rates. The result of our work were very good, and this allowed us to publish two scientific articles inside the Journal of Cardiology of Cameroon in 2009. And this was very amazing for me because I was just 22 years old and my name was already on two pages of a scientific journal. So for the professor, I was the good guys. So a few weeks later, he called me and he said to me, Arthur, you have done a very good job. This is why I want to submit you another problem. In my work, I have so many patients who live in village, and every time they want to perform a cardiac examination, they have to come into town waiting for hours. And this is very long, very expensive for them. And it is also very difficult for me to follow them remotely. So can you think about a solution for this problem? And then later in 2010, I would discover that in Cameroon, there were only 40 cardiologists for more than 20 million persons. So it sounded like a duty for me, and I decided to do something. First, I will develop a software for my master's degree, which was able to perform heart examination on a PC, but I wanted to do more. So I wanted to develop a complete solution. And I was thinking about a solution that could include the hardware and the software, and this is how, progressively, the tablet appeared in my mind, and I decided to call it the Cardiopad, a medical touchscreen device used to perform heart examination, computer-assisted diagnosis, and medical data transfer for the telemedicine. But to develop this device, I will face two major difficulties. Firstly, the knowledge, and secondly, the money. Basically, I am a computer science engineer, so to implement this kind of project, I needed to learn electronics and English. So, thanks to a set of video courses provided by the Indian Institute of Technology, I successfully learned online the basic of digital electronics and embedded system. And this knowledge allowed me to design the tablet on the electronic end. But how to build my prototype without money? My work was not very formal, so I had no revenue. So fortunately for me, my mother, who is a nurse, believed in my project, and I asked her to take a loan from the bank for me, which she did. And previously, I had sent the electronic diagram of my prototype to Microsoft, and the project was selected for the regional final for a competition called Microsoft Imaging Cup for the year 2011. So Microsoft sent us a set of materials, including the hardware and the software used to develop embedded operating systems and programs. And using these materials, I was able to develop a small embedded operating system for the tablet, and I also developed a program that will collect and process the medical data on the device. Using the money obtained from the bank loan, I was able to purchase components that I needed, and I do the assembly with this component, and then I deploy the operating system and the program on the motherboard of the device. And at that moment, the prototype was finished, and I needed to transform this prototype in a first stock of complete devices. But to do that, I needed more money. And because at that moment, my family could no more fund this project, so I decided to use the internet to raise more funds. So I recorded a small video that I called Cardiopad First Last Demo, and I released this video on YouTube. And after posting and sharing this video on social media, the video got 3,000 views in 3 days. It was unbelievable for me. And this success of the project on internet involved many journalists to write many articles about the project. And this is how the president of Cameroon read an article about the project on a local newspaper, and he decided to grant me $37,000. With this grant, I formed a team, and I started to work with two local engineers in Cameroon. And I went to China to manufacture many devices. I met some entrepreneurs with whom I had been in contact before on the internet. So I was able to manufacture 30 complete devices. With my team, we continued to work on the development of the device and on the development of a large-scale data collection system until the end of the year 2012. And then, how to launch the project at a large scale? We didn't have enough money, so we decided to record another video demonstration showing how the Cardiopad works on a real patient and how it can be used to transfer medical data through a 3G network. And then, we released this video on the internet, and we submitted for the Rolex Award for Enterprise in 2013. And 1 year later, the Cardiopad won the first prize of the Rolex Award for Enterprise in the category of Applied Technology. Now the Cardiopad is being used in many places in Cameroon. For example, in Mbankoms, a small village located 25 kilometers from Yaounde, the capital, doctors and nurses use the Cardiopad to follow their patient. And as you can see, the Cardiopad comes with many applications inside, but to process an ECG examination, it is very simple. First, the nurse will attach this electrode on the chest of the patient, and this electrode will sense the heart signal of the patient. These electrodes are connected to this small module that contains a wireless data acquisition board. This data acquisition board will send the data of the patient to an ECG scope application with it inside the pad. This application will then collect, process, and store the data of the patient inside the memory of the Cardiopad. And then the data of the patient will be sent from the device of the nurse to the device of the cardiologist who is in charge to follow the patient. And then using another application, the cardiologist will produce a diagnosis for the patient, and then It will send it back, this diagnosis, to the nurse who is next to the patient. So the patient will not have to travel to the city to perform his examination. It will save money, it will save energy and time. And it will also allow the hospital to provide a better healthcare for the patient. So using the Rolex award, we will manufacture many devices to provide this device for every hospital in Cameroon where we need to perform health examination. What can we learn from this history? The most important thing that we can learn from this history is that technology is a powerful tool that can be used to improve the quality of life of human beings and the relationship between them. It is the best way for you to develop solution of problem of person around you, regardless of the context in which you are. But to do that, it asks you to be patient, to take time, and to never stop to believe in your idea. Thank you very much.